I can't even read that with the glasses on. Okay, you've got some money in the bank, you've done some saving, good job. Not quite enough to buy a house or invest in property, but you've always been told to make your money work for you. But how? In this video, I'm going to show you the four easiest ways that you can put that money into the stock market to beat inflation and hopefully loads more. This video is for entertainment purposes only. Information contained in this video is not and should not be taken as an offer or recommendation to buy any stock or share in the entire world. Back in April 2020, when the entire stock market crashed, I decided it would be smart to put the money that I had saved into some form of investment. I wanted to put it into the stock market, and I looked initially at how to invest in individual stocks, but I couldn't really find any easy way of doing it. I wanted to dip my toe in the water, essentially, and that's when I came across Stocks and Shares ISA. This is the first way and the easiest way that if you want to invest your money, you can do so. I did it through an app called Nutmeg. There's loads of different ones out there, but that's the one that I've got experience with, so that's the one I will talk to you about and show you. Nutmeg was really easy to get started with. The app invests the money for you. It invests it usually into quite stable indices and bonds. You can earn money on what you put in a Stocks and Shares ISA without having to pay any capital gains tax, and you don't have to touch it. You can lock it away and it steadily works for you in the background. You choose your risk level on the app and it'll invest your money accordingly. If you want your money to do better than it would in just a regular savings account in the bank, Stocks and Shares ISA is probably the way to go. So after about a year of leaving my money in Nutmeg to grow in the background, I decided I wanted to take a more active role in investing. I wanted to learn about being in the stock market and about day trading, about long-term trading. So from about Christmas time until March, I was being more aware and listening in on the news and different things like that to what's happening in the stock market. And then between March and April, that's when I moved my funds from Nutmeg to eToro. I used eToro because it is available in the UK. eToro has been great so far. I have really enjoyed it. It has a virtual trading account as well as your real trading account. So what this allows you to do, if you're quite nervous about just jumping in and putting your own money on the line, it will allow you to practice trading on stocks and shares with money that is paper. It doesn't exist. That leads me on to the second option of investing in stocks and shares that I have for you today, and that is to sign up to a platform such as eToro and use that to invest in indices. Now, what are indices? It's a group of stocks and shares that you can invest in as a whole. So you'll have heard of these before. There's the NASDAQ 100, that is the 100 biggest companies outside of the financial sector in the US. There's the SPX 500. You've got the FTSE 100, which is the UK version of that, the biggest 100 UK companies. So why would you want to invest? We'll use the NASDAQ 100 as an example. So essentially, it's low risk for long-term investors. Obviously, it goes without saying that it was affected by the pandemic. It will be affected by any future swing in the market, as will most of the stocks out there. But as you can see from this graph, the trend, when you zoom out from one day to a year or lifetime, is trending upwards. Even in April 2020, when the entire stock market crashed, you can see how quickly it bounced back. So thirdly, you can invest in individual stocks. Investing in one thing is seen as a more risky way to invest your money. However, an easy way to think about doing this is a look around you, look at the things in your life that you just can't see yourself living without, and you can't see a world that doesn't include those things. And if you invest in those things, then you invest in the things that you believe in, not just on the advice of others or what it says in the news or the hype of the current moment saying like, oh, this one thing is going up, put all of your money into it now. That's when people fall into a trap and they lose money. But if you invest in the things that you use daily and that you believe in and that you don't see going away anytime soon, then that's generally a good investment strategy. A pretty well-known investment strategy is called FANG. Facebook, Apple, Amazon, Netflix, and Google. And if you are invested in those companies, pretty much any stage, so if you go back 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, your portfolio would have done excellently. So a couple of years ago, those companies weren't small by any stretch, but they just continue to grow and grow and grow at a mammoth pace. And they don't really seem to have any intention of stopping. So can you think of a world that doesn't have any of those companies? Maybe, maybe not, I don't know, your personal views. But lots of people have taken on and adopted this strategy and it's paid off pretty well for them. The fourth thing that you can do as someone who wants to get involved in investing but isn't attracted by any of the three previous options, like putting your money in a stocks and shares ISA, where it's invested for you, putting it into an indices, which is pretty set and standard, or taking time to invest it in individual stocks yourself, there's another option. I'm not sure if it's offered on all trading platforms, but it is offered on eToro, and that's the one that I use. So that's the one that all of this is going to be kind of centered around. And that is copy investing. This is where you copy someone else's portfolio. So for an example, on eToro, if you click here, you can see all of the people whose portfolios you can copy. Click on this guy, let's see how he's doing. His performance over the last couple of months, you can see where it's red, you can see where it's green, and these are all the stocks that he's invested in. What you can do when you copy invest is you can allocate £500, let's say, to copying this guy because you like what he's got in his portfolio, and your £500 will copy the proportions of what he's investing into. So now let's say that you want to go and invest in someone else that aligns to your beliefs. So you want to invest in crypto. So you're going to invest in someone who has quite a large proportion of crypto in their portfolio. And when they sell, you will reap the rewards from that. And when they buy, you'll also reap the rewards from that. And you can see their track record, and it's a little bit more dynamic than just investing in indices or investing through a platform like Nutmeg, and maybe less risky than investing yourself. So as you can see, there's loads of opportunities out there, and you don't need to be Warren Buffett to get started. I really hope this was useful because I think that the stock market can be a really daunting place. And over the last 2 years, I've learned so much on how hands-off or hands-on you can be with your money. There's so many companies out there that benefit from the fear that people have of getting involved in the stock market, and they try to make you think that you need a financial advisor. Oftentimes, these indices, or as I said, investing in FANG, Facebook, Amazon, Apple, Netflix and Google, can have just as good rewards as paying someone else to invest your money for you. I'm not saying that I haven't made mistakes, and in the next video I'm going to share with you what the biggest regrets I have investing so far are and how you can avoid them.